This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina. Today's brief podcast is on American slave medicine, specifically diseases attributed to enslaved Africans. Note that the historical field of slavery in medicine is very large. The area includes numerous subjects, including but not limited to medical law, surgical procedures, day-to-day practices, botanical medicines, and of course, African agency. Many of these subjects, as well as those not listed, will be addressed in other podcasts and videos. At this time, we will briefly review four of the slave diseases under the area of pseudoscientific theories that emerged in the mid-19th century and provide an explanation regarding their nature and purpose. We come to understand the bases for Negro slave diseases through the work of Dr. Samuel Cartwright and other physicians. The four Negro slave diseases mentioned here include cachexia africana, consumption, drapetomania, and dysesthesia ethiopica. First, cachexia africana was a reference to dirt eating. This medical theory surmised that enslaved Africans, because of their indigenous African heritage, were prone to eating soil or clay. It was considered specific to the enslaved African population. Next is the disorder consumption, often referred to as Negro consumption when diagnosed among slaves. This form of consumption, meant to distinguish its existence from the form prevalent in white society during the antebellum period, included very broad diagnoses of respiratory and generic gastric debility. Third is drapetomania. This is the disease, according to Dr. Samuel Cartwright, that caused Africans to run away from bondage. Not only was a formal diagnosis offered for this condition, but one form of treatment or cure included beating the patient. Finally, we note among the Negro slave diseases, dysesthesia ethiopica. This disease cited, among its main features, general mental disability, mischief, and petty violence. Long before it became popular to do so, historians and Black Studies scholars critically assessed the diseases attributed to enslaved Africans, primarily for their racist import. All of these diseases are pseudo-theories, and while they may have possessed an observable physical condition, they consistently contained a fixed racist attitude on the parts of whites and a psychological component adjusted specifically for Blacks, and only ascribed to people of African descent. For example, cachexia africana was thought to have been inherited from Africa, meant to demonstrate Black inferiority and justify slavery as a civilizing experience. Today, a similar practice has been clearly delineated as pica, a worldwide syndrome which affects a diverse group of people for a variety of reasons. It refers to the small oral intake of clay. In consumption, the racist psychological component suggested that Africans possessed a vastly different physiology, that their bodies were different from whites from their external skin color to their internal organs. Today, consumption is regarded as a time-worn reference to tuberculosis. The most heavily critiqued among the slave diseases is drapetomania, and has been cited for its anti-normative and illogical approach to assessing human behavior in African people. It supported the aims of the pro-slavery argument by suggesting that it was mentally incongruent for Blacks to desire freedom, and that they could not envision any form of liberty for themselves. Thus, Africans who had such thoughts or acted by attempting to liberate themselves must have been suffering from a mental disability. Finally, and similarly, diesthesia ethiopica confirmed Southern attitudes about blacks, attitudes which socially profiled them in negative terms. American slave medicine is a large field and includes the area encompassing the discussion of medical conditions and diseases attributed to blacks. Not all physicians during the antebellum period supported these theories. Medical journals did, however, publish these ideas alongside their mainstream articles, and a select number of medical journals treated these slave diseases with a fair amount of clinical derision. However, the criticism was often for the faulty medical bases, such as a lack of clear diagnosis and limited subject basis, not for the white supremacist implications in the field of medicine. We also note here that some of these diseases were prominent in antebellum medical dictionaries and handbooks used by Southerners. Most of the medical conditions assigned to African people before the Civil War, such as these four examples of slave diseases, cachexia africana, consumption, drapetomania, and diesthesia ethiopica, are examples of pseudoscientific thought, rooted in racist medical doctrine designed to maintain white supremacy in the South. This objective sought to further embed social distance between whites and blacks by scientifically validating false ideas. The highest aspect of this goal was to deprive Africans in bondage of their humanity.